हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन सेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8th हिस्ट्री। इन दिस सेशन वी विल लर्न चैप्टर नंबर 14, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्टेट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र। स्टूडेंट्स, द स्ट्रगल फॉर इंडिपेंडेंस फ्रॉम द ब्रिटिश राज वाज एन एक्सट्रीमली सिग्निफिकेंट बैटल दैट इंडिया फॉट। एंड आफ्टर इंडिया गेन्ड इंडिपेंडेंस देयर वाज demand on large scale for the reconstruction of states on linguistic basis. Students, linguistic means based on language. In 1915, Lokmanya Tilak had demanded the reconstruction of a state based on language. But during that time, the issue of independence of India was more important. Hence, this issue remained aside. Students, when did Lokmanya Tilak demanded the reconstruction of a state based on language? In 1915. And during that time, the issue of independence was very important. Hence, the issue of reconstruction of a state based on language remained aside. Students, in this lesson we will study how from 1946 onwards in Maharashtra, the demand for the state of Marathi speaking people led to Sanyukt Maharashtra movement, and how this movement progressed, and finally the state of Maharashtra came to be formed on 1st May 1960. Students, see this map of India of 1956. Can you see Maharashtra state? No, because before 1st May 1960, there was no separate state for Marathi speaking people. In place of Gujarat and Maharashtra, you can see Bombay state. It was bilingual state with majority of Gujarati and Marathi people. So they demanded for the separate state. Students, first we will learn how Sanyukt Maharashtra movement was taken place. From the beginning of 20th century, many scholars had begun to express the thoughts on unification of Marathi speaking people, means all Marathi speaking people should be united in one state. When British government suspended the partition of Bengal in 1911, on this background, N.C. Kelkar wrote that the entire Marathi speaking population should be under one dominion, means under one state. And finally, on 12th May 1946, in the Sahitya Sammelan at Belgaon, an important resolution regarding Sanyukt Maharashtra was passed. Students, Sahitya Sammelan means it is an event organized for writers, poets, authors who come together and they discuss on literature, arts, culture, etc. So, on 12th May 1946, these authors, poets were gathered at Belgaon, where they demanded for Sanyukt Maharashtra. In this lesson, we will study how was Maharashtra state formed. What movements were carried for the formation of the state of Marathi speaking people, that is Maharashtra? Sanyukt Maharashtra Parishad. On 28th July, Maharashtra Ekikaran Parishad was called at Mumbai. Students, why was this meeting called? What was their motive? Their motive was to demand that all Marathi speaking regions should be included in one state. What resolution was passed in this meeting? That all Marathi speaking regions should be included in one state, including मुंबई, सेंट्रल प्रोविंसेस एज वेल एज मराठवाड़ा एंड गोमंतक. एंड हु वॉज द प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ दिस मीटिंग? शंकर राव देव वॉज द प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र एकीकरण परिषद. Several committees were set up in regard with the formation of linguistic provinces, means language-wise provinces. First, we will learn about Dhar Commission. When was this commission established? And was this commission successful in forming the linguistic states? Let us learn in detail about Dhar Commission. Dhar Commission was established on 17 June 1947 by the President of Constituent Assembly, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, under the chairmanship of Justice S.K. Dhar. On 10th December 1948, the report of Dhar Commission was published, but the issue of forming linguistic provinces still remained unsolved, due to which another committee was set up, that is JVP committee. This committee was of three ministers committee, known by the initials of the members Jawaharlal Nehru, Vallabhai Patel and Pattabhi Sitaramaya. The Congress appointed this committee on 29th December 1948 to study the conditions of the creating linguistic provinces. And the report of this committee suggested that Congress accepted the concept of linguistic state, but according to Congress, this was not the proper time to form the linguistic states. Therefore, people of Maharashtra were against this report. During that time, Senapati Bapat organized rallies for awakening of the people to make them realize now it's time to demand the formation of the state of Maharashtra. Students, Mumbai wanted to be the part of Maharashtra. And it was also proved by Acharya Atre, as he got passed the proposal of Sanyukta Maharashtra with Mumbai in the Mumbai Municipal Corporation. It got passed by 50 against 35 votes. Thus, due to majority votes, the desire that Mumbai should be included in Maharashtra was proved. But the issue of formation of linguistic states was still unsolved. Therefore, Commission for Reconstruction of States was set up. Let us learn, was this committee successful to form linguistic states? Government of India appointed a Commission for Reconstruction of States on 29 December 1953 under the chairmanship of Justice Fazal Ali. Students, what proposal did this commission presented? The proposal for the creation of bilingual Mumbai state. When was this proposal presented? On 10th October 1955. Students, bilingual means two languages. This proposal advocated for creation of bilingual Mumbai state, means Mumbai will contain the people of two languages, and it was Gujarati and Marathi. Nagpur Pact. Now, what was the purpose of Nagpur Pact? Marathi people of all regions should resolve to make one state was the purpose of signing the Nagpur Pact in 1953. And which regions were included in it? According to this pact, Sanyukta Maharashtra was formed, including Western Maharashtra and Vidarbha along with Marathwada. And assurance was given regarding equitable financial provision for the developmental work ample finance for technical and vocational education, provision of state government services in particular region according to the population, and assembly session once in a year should be held in Nagpur. So, finally, there was a change brought in the constitution. According to the Article 371, Clause 2, Nagpur Pact was included and accepted, and accordingly, assurance was given regarding equal financial provision for developmental work, education, provision of state government, but students, inclusion of Mumbai was not mentioned in the Nagpur Pact. Students, as we studied before, the people of Mumbai wanted to be the part of Maharashtra. Therefore, the struggle of Marathi-speaking people for formation of Maharashtra with Mumbai had started. What did people do for the formation of Maharashtra with Mumbai? A huge meeting was held on Kamgar Maidan in Mumbai. At that time, Shankarao Dev said, "We will oppose the separation of Mumbai from Maharashtra up to our last breath." Public agitations were taken place. Even women like Sumati Bai Gore, Ismat Chuktai, Durga Bhagwat, Tara Reddy, Charushila Gupte, Kamlatai More, Sultana Johari participated in this agitation. On 7th November 1955, there was meeting of labors. Various political parties participated in it. Comrade Shripad Amrud Dange presided over the session. In this meeting, S.M. Joshi demanded Sanyukta Maharashtra with Mumbai and Vidarbha should be created. Students, what did S.M. Joshi demanded? S.M. Joshi proposed a resolution that Sanyukta Maharashtra with Mumbai and Vidarbha should be created. Now, let us learn about the beginning of actual conflict. The struggle of formation of Maharashtra with Mumbai was going on becoming more intense. Discontent among the Marathi speaking people was growing. Senapati Bapat led Grand March, which was taken to Vidhan Sabha. Morarji Desai was the chief minister at that time. The government declared ban on this march. The police started lathi charge and used tear gas. Students, tear gas is a type of gas which is used by the police to control the mob. This gas hurts the eyes and throat through which people are unable to continue with their activity. Therefore, during the march led by Senapati Bapat, tear gas was used by the police to put an end to their activities. On that evening, an open meeting was conducted on Kamgar Maidan. A mob of around 50,000 people was gathered at this meeting. Comrade Dange guided the people. A decision of one-day token strike was taken to accelerate the struggle for the Sanyukta Maharashtra movement. Establishment of Sanyukta Maharashtra Samiti. The issue of the demand of Marathi-speaking people started becoming more complicated. A meeting was conducted on 6th February 1956 under the chairmanship of Keshavrao Jede at Tilak Smarak Mandir in Pune, in which Comrade Shripad Amrud Dange was the president, Dr. T.R. Navarane was the vice president, and S.M. Joshi was general secretary. G.T. Madholkar, Acharya P.K. Atre, मधु दंडावटे, प्रबोधनकर केशव ठाकरे, वाई के सोनी प्लेड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन एस्टेब्लिशिंग द समिति. एट द सेम टाइम सेनापति बापत, क्रांति सिन्हा नाना पाटिल, लालजी पेंडसे, अहिल्याबाई रांगणेकर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू द संयुक्त महाराष्ट्र मूवमेंट ऑन अ लार्ज स्केल. वेन इट वॉज क्लियर दैट मुंबई विल नॉट बी इंक्लूडेड इन महाराष्ट्र, एट दैट टाइम देर अरोज अ ह्यूज पब्लिक एग्रिटेशन इन दिस मूवमेंट. 106 पीपल सेक्रीफाइज्ड देयर लाइफ इन द फायरिंग ओपन्ड बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. एंड लेटर हुतात्मा स्मारक वॉज इरेक्टेड इन मुंबई नियर फ्लोरा फाउंटेन इन द मेमोरी ऑफ द पीपल हु सेक्रीफाइज्ड देयर लाइफ फॉर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ संयुक्त महाराष्ट्र. ऑन 1st November 1956, bilingual Mumbai state came into existence. But the people of Mumbai were against bilingual state. They wanted to be the part of Maharashtra. Later, in 1957, Lok Sabha, Vidhan Sabha and Mumbai Municipal Corporation elections were held. And the results of the elections made it clear that the voters were against bilingual state and they were in the favor of Sanyukt Maharashtra. On 30th November 1957, Sanyukt Maharashtra Samiti held demonstrations during the inauguration of the statue of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj at Pratapgarh at the hands of Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. This demonstration was led under the leadership of Bhai Madhavrao Bagal. Leaders like S.M. Joshi, N.G. Gore, Jayant Rao Tilak, P.K. Atre, Udhav Rao Patil were also present. Severe demonstrations were made at Pasarni Ghat and Polatpur. The Samiti succeeded in making Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru aware of the conditions as well as the sentiments of Marathi-speaking people that they wanted to be the part of Maharashtra and they were against the bilingual state. And the central government favored the making of Maharashtra due to the agitation led by Sanyukt Maharashtra Samiti. Indira Gandhi, the president of Congress, supported the Sanyukt Maharashtra movement. The central government consented the two linguistic states, that is Maharashtra and Gujarat. In April 1960, the parliament passed the Mumbai Reorganization Act. According to this act, Maharashtra state was formed on 1st May 1960. At the dawn of, dawn means early morning, at the beginning of the day, that is on 1st May 1960, in the special ceremony at Raj Bhavan, on occasion of Labor Day, Pandit Nehru officially announced the formation of Maharashtra state. And who became the first Chief Minister of Maharashtra? Yashwant Rao Chauhan accepted the responsibility as first Chief Minister of Maharashtra. Students, now let us learn about the contribution of Marathi newspapers and Shahis towards Sanyukt Maharashtra movement. In this movement, the role of newspapers was very important, as through these newspapers, people were inspired to take part in the Sanyukt Maharashtra movement. Now let us learn about the newspapers who brought awakening among the people. Prabodhan, Kesari, Sakal, Navkal, Navyug, Prabhat, many such newspapers worked for the awakening of the people. Acharya Atre started the Maratha newspaper, which played an important role in Sanyukt Maharashtra movement. Balasaheb Thackeray took up the pen name Mawla and drew caricatures to make the movement comprehensive. Students, caricature is picture that makes his or her appearance more funnier than it is in reality. लोग शाहिर अना भाऊ साठे, शाहिर अमर शेख एंड शाहिर डी एन गावनकर थ्रू देयर राइटिंग्स अरोज्ड पब्लिक अवेकनिंग ऑन अ लार्ज स्केल. इन दिस वे न्यूज़पेपर्स एंड पोएट्स प्लेड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन ब्रिंगिंग अवेकनिंग अमंग द पीपल फॉर पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन संयुक्त महाराष्ट्र मूवमेंट.